Good morning, students. In the previous classes, we learned about transportation in plants and circulation in animals. Shall we recall them? First one, what are the components of blood? Do you know the answer? Yes, plasma and blood cells are the components of blood. Next one, name two-layered protective covering of human heart. Pericardium is a two-layered protective covering of human heart. Third one, what is the shape of RBC in human blood? The shape of RBC in human blood is biconcave and disc-shaped. Mention the artery which supplies blood to the heart muscle. Coronary muscle supplies blood to the heart muscle. Today we are going to learn about blood groups. What is blood group? A blood type is also known as blood group. Blood group is a classification of blood based on the presence and absence of antibodies and antigenic substances on the surface of red blood cells. A blood group is a classification of blood based on the presence or absence of antibodies and antigenic substances on the surface of red blood cells. What are antibodies? Antibody is a protective protein produced by our immune system. Antibody is a protective protein produced by our immune system. What are antigens? Antigens are toxic substances or toxic proteins. Toxins are other foreign substances which induces an immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies. So antigens induces the immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies. Antigens may be proteins, carbohydrates, glycoproteins or glycolipids depending on the blood group system. Antigens may be proteins, carbohydrates, glycoproteins or glycolipids depending on the blood group system. What are antigens? Antigens are toxic substances. The toxic foreign substances which induces an immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies. So antigens are toxic substances which induces an immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies. Okay, the concept of blood grouping was developed by Carol Landsteiner in 1900. The concept of blood grouping was developed by Carol Landsteiner in 1900. Do you know what are the types of blood? A, B, AB and O. Okay, this Carol Landsteiner identified blood groups A, B and O. He identified only three blood groups. They are A, B and O. But AB blood group was recognized by De Castello and Staini. AB blood group was recognized by De Castello and Staini in 1902. The concept of blood grouping was developed by Carol Landsteiner. He identified only three blood groups. They are A, B and O. But AB blood group was recognized by De Castello and Staini. Human blood contains certain specific substances called agglutinogens or antigens. It is also known as AG. Human blood contains certain specific substances called agglutinogens or antigens. Next, agglutinins are antibodies. Agglutinins are antibodies, also known as AB. What are the specific substances found in human blood? They are antigens and antibodies. Antigens are also known as agglutinogens and antibodies are also known as agglutinins. Then, location of antigens and antibodies. You know that RBC contain cell membrane and cytoplasm. Antigens are found on the membrane surface of RBC. Antigens are found on the membrane surface of RBC. Antibodies are present in blood plasma. You already studied about plasma, isn't it? Yes, plasma is the liquid substance of the blood. These antibodies are part of our body's natural defenses. They recognize foreign substances such as germs and alert your immune system, which destroys them. Students, now we pass on to different types of blood in human. I already told that based on the presence or absence of antigens and antibodies, human blood group is classified into four groups. What are they? A, B, AB and O. These are the four types of blood groups. An individual has one of the four blood groups. An individual has one of the four blood groups. Shall we study them in detail? First one, A group individual. Look at the picture. There are two types of antigens. They are antigen A and antigen B. And two types of antibodies, antibody A and antibody B. In the picture, blue color denotes antigen A and purple color denotes antibody B. First, A group individual. In the A group individuals, antigen A is present on the surface of RBC, that is blue color balls, and antibody B is present in the plasma. So in A group individual, antigen A is present on the surface of RBC and antibody B is present in the plasma. Next, B group individual. In B group individuals, antigen B is present on the surface of RBC. Antigen B is present on the surface of RBC, that is purple color arrow. Antigen B is present on the surface of RBC and antibody A is present in the plasma. Antibody A is blue color, Y-shaped structure. Okay, can you see that? In B group individuals, antigen B is present on the surface of RBC and antibody A is present in the plasma. Okay. Next, AB group individuals. In AB group individuals, both antigens A and B are present on the surface of RBC. Look at the picture. In AB group individuals, both blue color balls and purple color arrows are found on the surface of RBC. Can you see this? So, antigens A and B are present on the surface of RBC and both antibodies are absent in the plasma. In the plasma, there is no antibody. So, in AB group individuals, antigens only present, antibodies are absent. Next, O group individuals. In O group individuals, antigen A or B is absent on the surface of RBC. There is no blue color ball and purple color arrow. Antigen A or B is absent on the surface of RBC. However, the plasma contains both the antibodies A and B. Here antigens are absent, antibodies both A and B are present. Antibodies are Y-shaped. Can you see that? These are the four types of blood groups found in human body. What are they? A group, B group, AB group and O group. These are the four types of blood groups found in human body. They depend upon the presence or absence of antigens and antibody. Next, blood donation. Blood donation is a voluntary procedure that can help to save the lives of others. Blood donation is a voluntary procedure that can help to save the lives of others. In blood transfusion, we must consider the antigen and antibody between the donor and the recipient. We must consider the antigen and antibody between the donor and the recipient. Who is donor? The person who donate blood is called donor. Who is recipient? A person who receives blood is known as recipient. Okay, when an individual receives a mismatched blood group from the donor, agglutination of blood occurs. That is, if a person receives wrong blood group, it can be life threatening. So one should not receive mismatched group. Agglutination means clumping of particles. Agglutination is a Latin word. Here the antigen is mixed with antibody, so it leads to death. Antigen mixed with antibody, that is called agglutination. When it happens, if a person receives mismatched blood from the donor, this agglutination may occur. Okay, and it leads to death. Universal recipient. Persons with AB blood group are called universal recipients. Persons with AB blood group are called universal recipients. They can receive blood from persons with any blood group. So, they are called universal recipients. Universal recipients can receive blood from persons with any blood group. So, AB blood group are known as universal recipient. Next one, universal donor. Persons with O blood group are called universal donor. Persons with O blood group are called universal donor. They can donate blood to persons with any other blood group. So they are known as universal donor. So AB blood group is called universal recipient and O blood group is called universal donor. Rh factor. Have you heard about that word, Rh factor? Rh factor is an inherited protein found on the surface of RBC. If your blood has that protein, you are Rh positive. If your blood lacks that protein, you are Rh negative. Rh positive is the most common blood type. Rh factor was discovered by Landsteiner and Wiener in 1940. Rh factor was discovered by Landsteiner and Wiener in 1940 from rhesus monkey. What's the name of the monkey? Rhesus. Rh factor is named after the rhesus monkey, which is the animal where it was identified. Rh factor is named after the rhesus monkey, which is the animal where it was identified. The surface of RBC contains the antigens for Rh factor. The surface of RBC contains the antigens for Rh factor. Look at the picture. Rh positive persons have Rh antigen on the surface of RBC. Rh positive persons have Rh antigen on the surface of RBC. But Rh negative persons do not have Rh antigens on the surface of RBC. Rh positive persons have Rh antigens on the surface of RBC. But Rh negative persons do not have Rh antigens on the surface of RBC. This is the difference between Rh positive and Rh negative. Next, Rh antibodies.
It is very simple. Antibodies developed against this RH antigen is called RH antibodies. Antibodies developed against this RH antigen is called RH antibodies. Lymphatic system. What is lymphatic system? Lymphatic system is a part of our immune system. It is the network of vessels through which lymph drains from the tissues into the blood. Lymphatic system comprises of the following four parts. They are lymphatic capillaries, lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, and lymphatic ducts. Look at the picture. You can see these parts, lymphatic nodes, lymph nodes and lymphatic ducts. Lymph is a fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. Lymph is the fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. The lymphatic capillaries unite to form large lymphatic vessels. Lymphatic capillaries are minute. These lymphatic capillaries unite to form large lymphatic vessels. Lymph nodes are small, oval or pear-shaped structure located along the length of the lymphatic vessels. Lymph nodes are small, oval or pear-shaped structure located along the length of the lymphatic vessels. That's all about lymphatic system. Next, what is lymph? Lymph is a colorless fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. Lymph is a colorless fluid that flows through the lymphatic system. It is formed when plasma, proteins, and blood cells escape from the cells into intercellular spaces in the tissues through the pores present in the walls of capillaries. Lymph is similar to blood plasma. That is, it resembles the blood, but it is colorless and contains less proteins. It also contains very small amount of oxygen, carbon dioxide, water, and white blood cells. Lymph is a colorless fluid and it is similar to blood plasma, but it is colorless. It contains very small amount of oxygen, carbon dioxide, water and white blood cells. Functions of lymph. What are the functions of lymph? Lymph supplies nutrients and oxygen to the parts where blood cannot reach. That is, it transports oxygen, hormones and nutrients to different parts of the body where blood cannot reach. Because blood flows through blood vessels. Lymph flow through lymphatic vessels. Second point. Lymph drains away excess tissue fluid from the body tissues. That is, it removes metabolic wastes from the cells and tissue fluid from the body tissues. The lymph also carries absorbed fat from small intestine to the blood. It absorbs fatty acids from small intestine and transport of fat to the circulatory system. Next function, production of immune cells. This lymph produces immune cells such as lymphocytes, monocytes, and antibody producing cells called plasma cells. They defend the body from infection. Then what are the functions of lymph? Supplies nutrients and oxygen to the parts where blood cannot reach. It drains away excess tissue fluid from body tissues. The lymph also carries absorbed fat from small intestine to the blood. Production of immune cells. These are the functions of lymph. Okay, that's all about blood group and lymphatic system. Students, I hope you can understand this lesson clearly. Now prepare well for the test. Thank you, students.